Before we proceed further, I take this opportunity to introduce our company. Dio Research and Engineering Private Limited is a 10-year-old company with 40 employees working and 11 consultants who are working from different verticals and different area. We are predominantly on the analysis segment only. So especially on the structural mechanics in macro level, start from the micro or the like the subatomic level to complete macro level of evaluation. Specifically to make it very short in terms of the polymeric material is concerned, we start working on molecular mechanics of the molecular dynamics of polymeric materials and composites, and then predicting its properties, characterizations and things like that. From there we go to the macro level, which is finite element applications, structural mechanics calculations of the material. From the structural mechanics of the macro level, we will move to the life calculation of the material. So we can by taking into consideration of any material, we can start from the nano applications to complete macro level life predictions. And on our life predictions or the durability assessment of polymeric, we work with a tool called Endurica. So Endurica is basically for system level evaluations of polymeric materials, rubbers, elastomers and other material life calculations. So the activities comes in multifold for us. One is on chemical, the molecular dynamics, quantum chemical calculations. Then we also work on chemical reaction kinetics aspects, where we work on ChemKin or chemical workbench as a software, and then to the macro level part of it. So we have a different people with a different background. And moving ahead, so the next slide, it's basically what kind of COEs we have in-house. So we work on, we have a structural mechanics team which works from metals to alloys to polymers and other calculations. We have a manufacturing stream which will simulate the complete manufacturing process. It can be a rubber extrusions for our twin extruders modeling or these kind of things, compounding, all the aspects we can simulate it in the manufacturing process simulation. And the same one we work even in the like viscoelastic viscous fluid movement in fluid dynamics aspect. There is a specialized team which is works on material modeling and characterization. So that's where we are talking today. So the material modeling is a separate team at Dio. So this is a brief introduction of Dio Research and Engineering Private Limited. And we partner with a OEM called JSOL Corporation Japan. This is owned by NTT Data, which is Asia's biggest IT company, and which owns the JOCTA software, which is basically an integrated software platform for soft materials. So now we have integrations with the CSTA and other things. So JOCTA is basically an open architecture platform where you can work not only on the JOCTA solvers, you can even work on the other solvers as well. So let's get into the JOCTA aspects. So you can have more details of the JOCTA on j-octa.com. So JOCTA is predominantly used for plastics, rubbers, elastomers, thin film development, fuel cells. There are many cases. When you website, when you visit, you can see that a lot of case studies are listed. So depending on the scale and depending on the applications, the JOCTA different solvers are being used. So it can start from liquid crystal modeling to polymer chain model to phase separation to the meso or micro scale modeling of thin films and other applications. So JOCTA is supported with an OCTA platform. So OCTA is a national project in Japan, and which is started in 2002. As an open source platform, and which is being used worldwide till now also by more than 3,000 people. And JOCTA is exactly after 3 years, it is, OCTA is more of an engine. It's a solver platform. OCTA stands for Open Computational Tool for Advanced Material Technology. And JOCTA is started after 3 years of the initiation of OCTA project, where JOCTA started giving a GUI and parallel processing and what is required for high-end simulations and cover like the platform and making it easy to solve it and modeling part. So in that process, JAOCTA has developed a lot of modelers for Octa engines and also the separate parallel solver called VSOP, so which is basically for parallel MD engines. And now it is used more than 100 to 150 customers around the world, which includes the very larger Sumitomo Rubbers and many other larger companies as well. So there is a book by name Computer Simulation of Polymeric Materials, which is available on the Springer bookstore, where you can see the complete process, solver aspects, everything is explained it. When you get a chance, you can just go through the book, which is also gives you a sample example case studies of different applications. So this is an important slide which we wanted. We need to little spend a time. So JAOCTA starts from subatomic level of modeling and up to the macro scale, and it also helps you to take the multi-scale modeling from taking the data of the nanoscale model to the macro scale model, or let's say it's for Abacus or ANSYS or LS-DYNA or any other, to further processing of the models. So when it comes to quantum chemical calculation or first principle calculations, where we do a density function theory and part where we are to understand the electron state and interactions and polarizations, the reactions and other thing. So we have a integrated siesta inside the tool. So you need to observe two things here. One is the whatever is there in the bracket. These are all the softwares which are integrated and which provide. JAOCTA provides a modeler for that, and with the solver you can solve these cases inside JAOCTA only. Whereas which is outside the things which are owned by JAOCTA or JSOL, so which is part of for solving the various cases. For example, we have a siesta for energy calculation. Siesta is a well-known code from Spanish government project, and which is now it is extended as an ASAP, advanced simulation platform things, which will have a much more advanced features of modeling in the DFT based on atomic orbital method things, and AB Inchit is integrated inside JAOCTA for solving it. And you also have an options like Firebreak, Gaussian or Mopac, which whatever engine you want to use it. The modeler is already built in JAOCTA, so you don't need to change the model whatever built, but solver can be of your choice. And same way, when we move to the next scale, which is molecular dynamics scale, we have a G is silent Cognac model, as well as VSOP is equivalent to Octa solver, and but it can handle the parallel processing capabilities and other. So where we talk about more of molecular interactions and structure, thermomechanics, diffusion properties and things like that. And also you can model, you can bring the LAMMPS model inside JAOCTA, or JAOCTA model to LAMMPS, you export to LAMMPS. So it's a seamless integration between JAOCTA and LAMMPS, where we can utilize leverage the capabilities of both the softwares together. So if let's assume you have spent around 10-15 years or on building the models in the LAMMPS, and you suddenly you don't need to if you want to shift it to JAOCTA, you don't need to worry about it, because you can easily import those models and start working on JAOCTA and take the advantage of the JAOCTA and multi-scale modeling part. Next comes is Gromax as well as WMD. Apart from this, there are other tools are also associated with it. And then we have a tube model or a viscoelastic properties or hyperelastic properties material. The Mosodoy model is very famous in this domain. So which is Mosodoy is basically Edwards Mosodoy model is famous in this. And Mosodoy is he's the principal investigator of JAOCTA project, Octa project. And then moving to the SUSHI, that is the next level of modeling, where we have phase separations and DPD is applied. And moving ahead with the MUFIN is basically is an elastic modeler, and elastic mechanical properties can be derived out of it. And if you want a plastic properties, you can move to I'm just, sorry, I had to mute the things. Okay, so then you have a muffin which is can be used. So all these solver names are represent the food names of Japanese, and I think the structure shape also looks like that. So next is you have a different modeling capabilities available in Jocna. You can start from some chemical structure and then start building the whole model, or you can go with the system level modeling where you can take from the database and start building the model. And or the reaction modeling is also available in Jocna part. So if you have models in built molecular models built in SIP or PDF, PDB or .mol files or SMILES for especially for machine learning, LAMMPS models you can bring it. So which will help you in building inorganic, organic to inorganic interfaces and other capabilities. So which we have different force field calculation capabilities built inside Jocna, and you have a choice of selecting whatever force field you wish to use it. And we have a link to interface to other commercially available the force field calculators also. So quantum chemical calculations basically we do with these above solvers. And CSTA is integrated inside, and we support them with for complete inorganic interfaces. CSTA itself is a energy interface tool. The portion is only implemented in Jocna, but however, it is CSTA is now called as commercial name of the CSTA is AACP, Advanced Simulation Platform, which is available now for users to. Use it for different applications, for metals to allies to the interface modeling and things. So this is basically a quantum chemical calculations, which especially the DFT and then the SDF theories were implemented. Next is just a few example to show you like how bigger the model you can go and how you can change in predicting the stress strain curves or mechanical properties of the model. So we may not be able to model these bigger systems now and demonstrate to you, but just to share some of the cases, and you will find a lot of them on the website also. So this is one of the cross-linking of epoxy resin, and see the reactions where we said it can go with the distance criteria between the two reacting atoms, or it can be based on the Monte Carlo using the activation energy based calculation or heat of formation. So yeah, whichever you select accordingly, the interactions, the reactions between the two atoms happens. So for example, this is an the bond formation between epoxy and amine, where CSTA is being used for calculating this reaction path calculations. So you can use the advantage of the solver capabilities in CSTA for the reaction simulation. And the next level of this is becomes a calculation of the elastic modulus, where we have a stress strain curve being developed. And this is one case where you can see the comparison between the experimental and simulated. So evaluated is around 4.22 and the experiment is in 3.76. So you can approximate the complete capabilities. This one case is done by one of our customers, Sumitomo Packard, and they are the biggest users of Jocna. Here, they started working on at atomic level, where they have removed the two reactive carbons at the nearest neighbor, and then hydrogens are removed to model it. So when you take such models and calculate the TG, gas transition temperatures and other, so you will have a percentage of cross-linking as it changes. You will also have the TG getting changed. And as it changes, you can see the stress strain curve also changes. So it is basically you can tune the model as you wish, and you can experiment it and then get the stress strain curve. So in the mechanical property, we predominantly look at the stress strain curve of the material. So this will give us an idea like whether my strength of the material is increased or decreased, or what need to be done for improving the properties of the material. We also have free volume and solubility calculation. So it's not permeability is not a direct output from Jocna, but it can be automatically computed with a diffusion and solubility coefficient calculated. So this is one such case where you can have a diffusion of the molecules calculated with the experimental to simulate it. And this case is basically it's like oxidation of silicon carbide by O2 and H2O. So here ReaxFF is being used with the LAMMPS solver for a silicon carbide material, and GeoCta is used to, in coordination with that, to predict the complete, this is a complete GeoCta material, molecular dynamics simulation. From the initial structure to the final structure can be you can see the initial structure and final structure on the right hand side. So this slide is to summarize, like, you can do any complex MD molecular dynamic simulations in combination with GeoCta and LAMMPS inside the GeoCta itself. And then we have CGMD modeling, where we can do a fully atomistic or post-grained modeling potential. So using the the bond potential or non-bond potential, you can calculate the complete CG model. Once you build that model, you can have a similar, you can start introducing the fillers and polymers, and this completely makes it more easier for us to perform the elongation analysis. The elongation analysis is basically, you will give you the stress strain curve. So you can have DOE conducted here to understand the influence of the deformation speed between the two. Next is, this is a customer who has done with an Yokohama rubber, so tires manufacturer, with a Kramer-Gress model. So we will be modeling this in the later part of this webinar, where not this this whole case study, but we will be using Kramer-Gress model to find out the the stress strain curve. So the idea here is, this paper work, they have taken two different kind of structures, dispersed and aggregated structure, and they could able to find the complete SSS group. So you can set up such kind of simulations where you can simulate the polymer folding, stretching, unfolding behavior in GeoCta. Next comes is slurry coating modeling. You can use for bead spin models like particle, polymer, and solvent cases. This is done for a fuel cell applications in Toyota, and which is used for complete macro level model. After you get, once you get this structure, you can just export that to the LS-Dyna for seeing the how the failure happens. So this is more important when you want to evaluate in terms of mechanical and a bigger structure, you want to export it. We have a voxel mesh exporting facility to the macro course, which is like LS-Dyna, Abacus, Ansys. For LS-Dyna, it is a direct interface we have created. For Ansys, Abacus, you can take an INP file and then import it inside the Abacus and perform and CD in the same case with the text file, ASCII file import in for Ansys is concerned. So this is an evaporation process highlighted, and then we calculate the mean field for bigger models where you want to use the interfacial strength being calculated. And this is a multi-scale modeling capabilities in GeoCta. So you can start from small atomistic model and then move on to the macro scale model to see that how the properties vary. And also you can make the reverse mapping. So we will show one of the reverse mapping properties calculation today. I have two cases to demonstrate today, and with the time constraint, let me see if I can add another few. But the idea is to demonstrate to you the procedure, how to it can be done. So when it comes to a macro level of finite element modeling, you can have a basic model created in GeoCta and export is an voxel mesh, and then perform the elastoplastic analysis for hyperelastic material or properties, or any viscoelastic properties. You can apply it and then perform the a nonlinear analysis of interfacial failures and nothing. Or if you have a micro FEA course like Digimat, other course, you can use that from GeoCta to the micro code, and from micro code you can perform the FEM analysis also. So GeoCta supports you in macro, directly to the macro, from nanoscale to the macro scale, and also it supports from the nanoscale to the micro scale modeling aspects. This is one such case where you have a two polymers blend and the strength of the interface is being studied. I think we will be doing a similar case today to demonstrate to you. And this is another set of case where we are going to use the the sushi model combined with of that of the Koyak model or the coarse-grained molecular dynamic model. So this case also I think we will be modeling today. So these two cases are of industrial applications. So there is a paper, complete paper reference you can see at the bottom, and which can be used for evaluating the for more detailed of this case. Okay, how we model that I'm going to demonstrate today, but as I said, like, we are simplifying the model because of the time constraint, but you can go through this model and repeat at your end also. So this also has the paper at the reference you can see at the bottom. So there is a paper reference which can be used for modeling, and we can have any kind of polymer blend modeling with the like phase separator structure for elastic analysis capabilities. So coming to the nonlinear analysis, you can do a direct calculations with a geocta, as I said earlier. So this is the demonstration, and this is evaporation process in the phase separator structure, how the evaporation happens. And this is an important case. I think many of you may be working on composite material. So you can set up the complete composite material with a mesostructure case, where you can change the interface cohesive zone portions, and you can see the interfacial property in the peeling simulations applications, where normal surface and modified. So in the normal surface, it is the distance of the cohesive zone is very less, and the modified surface has a more cohesive zone property, and which in fact helps, you can just observe the crack generation. You can see that the crack starts developing here, and this one, the first one to make it, it takes more time. So dispersed and modified structure can bear more load compared to the normal and aggregated structure. So this kind of cases can also be studied. And apart from that, we can develop a viscoelastic property for especially for tire modeling, things like tan delta for rolling resistance. So, and you can calculate the storage and loss moduli for given polymeric material. So we also have implemented machine learning capability in the software, and this we are shortly will be having one more webinar on how to how you can use the machine learning within geocta to predict the property, especially QSPR and deep learning part. So this is just to introduce the geocta aspect. So we will start the geocta demonstration part, where we can start modeling and then see that how to develop the how to develop the stress strain curve for that. So the idea is there are four different, where we have a coarse-grained molecular dynamics, where the physical model chemical is not chemical portion is not taken into account. The other one is the coarse-grained molecular dynamics model with the chemical model is taken into account. So, and then SCF, that is the sushi model combining with an coarse-grained model, and then we also have dissipative particle dynamics. These are four cases planned. Let's see, if the time permits, we will have all the four. At least the two of them will demonstrate today. So coming to coarse-grained molecular dynamic, the physical model model. So here we will be using a bead swing or Gremmer-Grist model, where the arbitrary parameters are taken into account to understand more of if the dimensional results are not necessary, then we can just go with the qualitative tendency to understand the mechanism and its behavior under different property. Especially like the when you want to compare the stress strain curves and other things, so you can start with the Gremmer-Grist model or bead spin model, which is called. So with that model, you will be able to calculate the rough estimation of the stress strain curve, and which is also be a quicker model to take it up. So let me shift to geocta window. Is it visible? Can somebody comment in the whether it is visible or not? Okay, thank you. So we'll start with an we'll start the new project, and the new project we are going to do here is the CGMD model with the camera. So I'll give project name as CGMD and the KG model. See, one thing you need to keep in mind while doing any naming in the JOCTA, you should not give any space here. Okay, so the space is not allowed in any cases. Either you use underscore or you use a hyphen while modeling. Even you also ensure, especially this left, the whole folder length which will go for solver should not have any space in the link. Okay, so we will start with an webinar model case here. So I'll start. The project is started. Let me close this windows, and then this is a project window where we will start modeling. The first is monomer. So let me take this monomer's model. Let me say that monomer one, and you can save it. So once you get into the model, there are multiple levels of modeling. Let me also demonstrate to you here with the tool. So when you have a file, you can convert that from see here, from Gromax to Cognac, Cognac to Gromax interfaces are there. LAMPS to Cognac, Cognac to LAMPS. So these two-way coupling available. You can have a Smiles models taken into here, and you can import many of other cases also. So these are depending on your applications, you can use this facility. And coming to this, the window where we are going to model it. So you have a different from the chemical structure, or you can go with the bead spin model or united, and then depending on your problem, you can select that. So here we are going with the chemist model. So I'll be taking three monomers. Let me first have one bead spin taken, and we will add the terminator at both the ends, so that this will help me in while making a polymer. It will have the repeating thing. So I would require three monomers. Let me adjust this horizontally, and I would require three monomers to model it. And let me save this. So this creates a one bead spin monomer model, and let me take another one, which is monomer two, and then go to bead spin, and then just drag and drop, and then take the two terminators, and let me quickly build this model. And let me just horizontally save this. So I'll create one more monomer. Let's say monomer three, and then go to bead spin, and then take the bead spin models. So go to terms. You can make it when you move the mouse, you will get a small blue color window where you can have this things built. So I have created three monomers. Let me move to creating the polymers. Let me create a polymer one, which is basically a polymer. Polymer two as a cross linker. So I'll be creating a two polymers. One is P1, which is basically polymer one for the polymer. So where I'll be adding monomer one and two, which I created. So I can just add monomer one, and let me add the another monomer also, monomer two. Okay, so these two monomers. So I'm making these two monomers to repeat in a certain pattern. So you can have individual repeating or changing. So I will make this to repeat about, I'm giving smaller numbers so that I can show the result. So this is here, and let me connect these two, and then have adjust horizontally. Yeah, so it's good now. So repeat the whole unit by the 10 times. Okay. So now I have my, the polymer one is created with the two monomers. Let me create the another polymer, which is P2. And here I'm going to add the monomer to three, which I created. So I'll not be repeating this. Let me have this. It's a cost linker, so I will keep that as it is. Save the things, and then we will go and start building the input file for input file for the Cognac modeler. So where I will just double click on the P1 and go to the Cognac. Okay, so we will just open this and then save and close. And I may need to do this also for other one. Sorry, the window is going off. And save and close. Now let me go to the Polymer one. Just start it. So here I'm going to add the P1 10 times, and I need to P2 is not there. So you can go here and add the P2. And okay, I think save it. Now let me add P2 here. Don't forget to save the file, otherwise it will say that it is not completed. So add things, and then it has added the P1 and P2. So now let's make it as let's create the input file here. So we can create the input file by clicking this button. So the input file is created. Click on save, and you can go to P1 here, and then you get the input file. Let's start setting up certain parameter of reactions and everything. So this depends on your problem. I've taken some parameter which can be quickly set, and so that we can have the results. So let me go with the time steps setting. So this I'll make it around 10,000, and I'll cut short this because it will take more time to run. So I'm making the number of intervals is very less. Then click on save, and then come to the reaction react conditions. So here react conditions, first let me switch on the react options. Then after this you need to have an reactive atoms calculate here. So bond creations part, so where you need to have the reactive atoms taken into account. So you need to do when in the here control E will add one creation option where you can give the name as let's say the B2 bead swing we have created, and then you okay. Before that, I think we'll do one thing. First, we needed two of such, so we can make another one, the reactive one and two. So in this case, so I'm giving a name of the B2. The bead spring 2, and then we can have it here, and then make it B3, and then make the number of bond as 3. Okay, so this is it depends on what kind of analysis you are performing, and in this case I'm considering the reaction conditions. So then we can go to the creation of the arrays, type arrays. So here you can set the parameter, the intervals of the reaction. Before that, you just make it as control E, so that you get editable editing options there, and add it as 1, and then probability 1.0. So then you can have a chain activated on, then it will take the creation type. So you can, in case of the creation type, you can take it as here the keyword, simple creation, not polymerization. So you also have a polymerization which you can use it later. Then we are going to have the threshold distances created. This is 1.2, I'm giving as a threshold distance. The potential name is between B1 and B2, it should happen. So then I'm going to give the sequence, what is the sequence it should be. So as I said, this is for this particular case it is correct, but in your case, depending on the things we need to study, like what are the parameters need to be changed. So, but the procedure remains the same. So, we have done with the complete setting up. So, I'll just repeat what I have said. One is I have set the dynamic condition of the model. Next is some reactions things I have said. So, you can apply the same thing for your models. And then let's go to save it, and then let's go to the solver, and then click on the solver. So I don't have more code here, so I'm just giving 4. Yeah, so it's completed 100%. Let me minimize this and close it, then save. So it's P2 output is ready. So I can go here and plot the things. You can see that it is created. You can see the interaction. So you can plot any of the parameter. If you come here, you have, like, if you want to, sorry, I think if you want to take it ball sticks, you can make it that. And these are just a plotting options available. So where you can use the different plotting options to model it. So now we have only created a structure with the reaction. So this is done. The structure is ready. Let's go ahead with the how do I make this to apply to calculate a stress strain curve. So till here, every model what you create will be the the procedure may differ, but as it comes to making an analysis in terms of the elongation simulation, from here whatever we do, this will be the procedure. Okay, so double click on this and you will get this window, which is output window. Now we are going to change the set the deformations for this. In the Go dynamic conditions, there is a deformation options where you just select the, there are multiple options like Lee Sadler, Edwards, then cell deformation. So we will go with the cell deformation, and then the what is that we are going, deformation rate or simple elongation. Right now we will take only the simple elongation part, and then if you expand it, so you need to give the elongation rate, so which can be 0.01 as an elongation rate, and the Poisson's ratio. Then it will ask for set the axis of evaluation. So let's take Z as an axis, and I can do this for longer period, but I'll take 10 and 1 as a value so that I can show you the results quickly. Okay, so but in your case, you depend on the applications, you can increase this portions. So let's come back to the initial structures here. So there are a couple of other things we need to set it in terms of taking. There is an initial structure, and in the initial structure, we need to go with the here I need to read the name. So I think I'll record 11 data as 11 here. So then taking those 11 data, and then let me go to react flag, react condition. So let me switch off the reactions now. So then here generation method resource. I think I need to do it as a restart here. So need to start record. Then record the 11 cells here. So 11. Let me make it as 1 and this one as 0. I have given all properties correctly. So 1 is initial structure. It has taken based on the density. You can give the cell size also. This model is unit cell is based on the density it is taking right now. In your case, if you are to go with the size of the unit model you want to define, then you need to make the initial cell size here. So you can change this cell size to edit it. Then if you want to have a CS style, you can make that. Record previous 11 I'm taking to restart analysis, and then with 11 and with the restore cell of each one, one as in a case. So I'm switching off the reaction conditions here. So and then let me move to the dynamic simulation time steps. So here I'm just taking let's say little bigger time steps, so around 2 lakhs, and then maybe make it as 10,000 as a string. So I think I'm done with all the property setting now. So let me go to the calculation engine and then run the calculations. It is showing 7 minutes, but it will be faster. I think we can see the results in another 2, 3, or 5 minutes time. So if you want to change the I'll just minimize this, let it happen. So I'll also explain what are the things you can do it in case if you wish to do a shear flow, then you can go to the deformation method here. Then where you can change the deformation method to Lee, here in this case you can change it to Lee Edwards and then submit it for the shear flow conditions. So after creating model, you don't need to every time go back and start developing from the scratch. You can play around with all data which you have given. They're all recorded here, so including the solver settings, type, everything. So yeah, I mean it is slip. I'm just solving this. In another case, I think I'll demonstrate in quickly and start building. Thank you. start seeing the results. Let's close this and go to JOCTA, refresh. I think we will have output created here. So you can go to the output standard. You can see that this is the initial structure, and you can see the okay, I'll just click in this direction. You can see that it starts the elongation property part. Okay, so and this elongation you can even go with the stress strain curve here, and when you go to stress strain curve, you can just you can plot with the non bonded display, or you can just go ahead with the things. So you can see the stress strain. It need to be very fine tuned when you go with, see, I have taken all demonstration properties. You need to increase the density, and you need to tune the model to get the better result and better curves here. So as we don't have much time, I will want to show one more the thing. So which will I'll try quickly start doing the another model. So I hope you got how to calculate the stress strain curves with the post strain molecular dynamics with a physical model. There are other results also to outsource. Sorry, see the things which are like density distributions part, like how the density distribution is done. So you can just do the analysis, and you can, if you are changing it to isosurface, you can see the isosurface. This is coming with an you can just, it is an initial structure, and it starts when you start making it, you will have the stretched one also. So if you are adding a, let's assume, composite material where you can add a filler and then the composite polymer and composite polymer composite filler and the polymer. In such cases, you can see the stretching happening, and accordingly, you can see the stress strain curve in the output parameter. Okay. So, in the output, you will see the things. There are other parameter also we can see here sometime. So, this is with the bonded with non-bonding, and if you switch off that, you can see the stress strain curve, and you also can have x by 2 on the shear side instances, stress in z directions. Okay. So I'm sorry, I had to rush to demonstrate another case to you. So let's go with the new project where we are talking about like sushi model, which is self-consistent field theory based things, and CGMD combined. This is very important thing when you want to do it in a system level modeling thing. For this, I need to create a sushi model first, which is a phase separated structure model. And let me go with the sushi modeler here. So I'll give name as sushi. Then I need to add two monomers here. So I can just add the segment here. Let's say A is one segment for me, my monomer. Another one is a B model. So here, then I need to create a polymer out of it. Let me say I'm creating a polymer of A100. So let me repeat this into set as 100, repeat. And then also create another one, which is B, with 100 repeats in the polymer level. So let me drag and drop this and then set that as 100. Say okay. And then I think I don't need this, I'll remove this. So now you have both the one part. So let's start creating the input file for sushi. The sushi input file is we need to create. So let's click on the sushi input file. And then you can have, I think, let me see. You can go to mesh, and where we are going to set the division, which is 48 as a division, and here also. So which is basically means that it, the sigma, the x is one value, and make it as Newman, which is which means that it is a reflective boundary conditions here. So and then go to the volume fractions. So we will set the volume fraction as 0.5 here, and then volume fraction for this as 0.5, and then we go with the with the let's say psi parameter, which is a interaction parameter. So let's set this as before setting the psi parameter, let me add the domain region, that is more important. So the domain region, I'm taking a A, and in the mid I want to calculate this property. So I've added the it's an initial volume fraction obtained interface at the midpoint of the region. And then we are going to add this SI parameter as 1.2 as an value, 0.2 as a value. And the 0.2 means it is a XN is 20 divisions. And then we can, now we are ready with the creating the things. Let's not change any other parameters. So I just repeat it. I have set the mesh, I have set the volume fraction, I have set the SI parameter and created a domain region here. And then we will just rename this as site parameter N20 and then input file and just say that create. So sushi input file is created. So you can expand the sushi input file, double click on it, and then you can start the analysis here. It will be quick, and then this is done with the sushi input file, and you can double click on this output to see that how the parameters is calculated. So execute it. Okay, sorry. I think I need to be in the last record. Initial record, definitely that will be zero, like that only. So now you can see the parameter with the midpoint. With 24, I have given as a mid, right? So it will take at the midpoint. So this is done with sushi. Let's save the sushi model and then go to cognac model. And we will create a two monomers for this because we need a cognac model initially to with the monomer with a bead spring model. So let me have as A as an monomer and go to bead spring, take bead spring one and then go to termins, terminator and then add these two terminators and then connect the two models and then say save. Okay, so this is monomer one and then let me create another monomer which is bead spring 2 and says save and then take bead spring and then go to the terms, add the term part and then add these two and then go to here, then just make it as don't get adjusted so you feel happy when it is properly aligned. So now we have done the monomer part, then we need to just go to the polymer things which will we will create the polymer here. So with the polymer one, P, we can have a polymer, name it as PA, and then add the monomer which is created with an monomer A, and then say okay, and then bring it here and right click, and then set the value as the 100, and which will basically repeat the 100, and we'll also make the cut, the cell to cut off as an 2.5 cell width, so you can change it depending on your analysis requirement, and save and close. And next is you create another polymer, and which you can name it as PP, and then say add the another the monomer which is created. So I may need another 10 minutes. I may extend little. So repeat it with the 100 and so we have this monomer created where we can say that 2.5 as an case. So cut off for the both the polymers. So the cutoff is being set. Save the things and then go to polymer A and where we need to set the input file we will create. So go to input file in the polymer A, you make it as 40 as an, so you need a polymer B, go to here polymer B, you load it. Select the B screen. Sorry. Okay, so here you can make it 40, and then basically we are making both assigned. So here you will rename it as an polymer polymer input, and then just create the polymer input file. Okay, so till here it was similar with whatever we have done earlier. So now we have a polymer input file created. Just save it, go to PA, then you have polymer input file here. So we will create now the cognac input file, the molecular mechanics file. Here in case we will take a bead spring model and name it as zoom property, which is basically the reverse property. So I need to merge both the sushi as well as the molecular model which I created. So for this there is an option. There are multiple options. We will take some time to explain each one of them. This is carbon nanotube, and we will have one webinar or demonstration on the same. So this is sushi cognac zooming the facility, where you can add the polymer which is created. So basically you have created a polymer one, and then you go to the same two times, because we need two part. So change this to here, and we have given 40 as a value. So here again 40 as a value. So you also created a density distributions file in the sushi. Go to the sushi and then select the output file, which is output of the sushi model. And when you load and convert, you will get an A for the bead spring one and B for the bead spring two. So let's make it a little more here to set the cell setting. I will use the same cell setting as 48, because then the density based thing. The density is added as a case. So you can make it reflective, periodic, other things. So it does not matter depending on case. So you have to write the file. Save, yes. Now it has started creating the structure. So what I'll do is I will just cancel this, because it will take another 5 to 10 minutes to do it. So I'm just canceling this. I have done kept one model ready for such demonstration. So you can yeah, after that you will get the structure like this. Okay, so this is one with the one the sushi output, and the other is the polymer output you're getting. So you will get a structure like this. Once the structure is ready, then you just have to go and set the input file portion. So where we can have for example with the cognac model, we can set the, let's say, go to the cognac models. So you can set the output. I'll just show you by creating another cognac model, just for a demonstration purpose, how you can set the things demo. And you can set the conditions here after you creating all the models, and then you can go here and set the conditions. In the condition, you can see that the earlier we have selected in the input file, here there is a GUI where you can set the values like Lees Edwards or cell deformation. If you cell deformation, this will get activated, simple elongation. Then you can go here and change the parameter, like what is the elongation ratio and Poisson's ratio you want to give it. So once this is done, you can go to non-bond potentials, where you can change the properties which is get listed after creating the model. So let me come back and show you the output file of this. So this is the output file with the stick. So you can see there's a model, and there's a solid model. Because I have given a periodic boundary condition, you can see the color is getting again continuing the same pattern here, and this side also you can see the continuity part of it. If you change it to reflective, you can see the you will see the reflective boundaries, like the same colored the polymer will repeat on the other side. So let me set to Z directions. You can see that this is elongated here, so this is more visible. You can see here there is a weakened sections get happens. Okay, so you can see here there is a stretching. That is what we were talking in our presentation. So where you can yes. This is with the sushi and other cases. You can see the models, then you can develop the stress strain curve based on that. So here to for the stress strain curve, you can go here and plot the stress strain curve. I have taken more data here. Maybe the stress strain curve will come very smoothly. Yeah. I hope the procedure is clear, so we can share the complete detail. So any questions, I'll be happy to answer. I think there are many. Let me take the questions part. I think so. Okay. I think somebody is asking tutorial videos on the. I'll stop the recording.